This tutorial will go over how to obtain a correct and meaningful analysis of the image scan ferroscan data in order to determine the layout, the depth, and the average diameter of the rebar. The Results button is used for adjusting the numeric processing of the data, which has a great influence on the quality and accuracy of the reinforcement analysis. Changing one of the settings automatically triggers reprocessing of the whole data set. The Overlay section is only applicable if the scan was made using an overlay, for example, when scanning an uneven surface. Only the actual cover depth is indicated, excluding the specified overlay thickness, which is covered separately by the thickness value. To activate this function, the On box must be checked. The rebar diameter value may be entered here if it's already known. For image scan, the auto option is applied by default. However, if the exact rebar diameter is known, it can be manually entered to improve the accuracy of the depth reading. The cover adjustment section allows horizontal and vertical adjustments of the measured depth while scanning reinforcing mesh or reinforcement arrangements, such as double rebar. With the aid of a factor, which is a linear value, and an offset, which is differential value, the measured depths can be brought in line with the actual depths. Always, several control points are required to determine the factor or offset that's applicable to the entire scan. The Measuring Point section shows the values of the object part closest to the crosshair, indicated as a red border in the visualization. An important precondition for taking correct rebar diameter and concrete cover measurements is to determine which rebar layer is on top, the horizontal or the vertical. This can be done using the Z slider under the Visualization Function button. If the vertical rebar appears before the horizontal one, then the vertical rebar is the top layer, which must be used for taking measuring points. The most accurate rebar diameter and concrete cover calculations are performed in the middle of two grid lines at positions which are as far as possible from neighboring rebar. To avoid having incomplete signals, the reference grid for data recording should be positioned so that the rebar lies at least 30 millimeters inside the reference grid. Under the Recorded Measuring Point section, the added measurements with all association values are listed. Double-click to add a measuring point. Once added, the rebar diameter, cover, position, orientation, and status are given. New measurements can also be added, deleted, or exported in a CSV format. Users can select which data is visualized, standard, analyzed, or not analyzed. Here, the unverified measurements can be excluded by unchecking the Unverified box. The content of the report can be customized using the configuration feature. By checking or unchecking the element boxes, users can choose to include or exclude information from the visualization. Under Extras, a report can be generated including the visualization on the screen and anything that's been added to the scan file, for instance, measuring points.